I'm running for chief because for several months now, the elders have approached me and asked me if I would seriously consider running for the upcoming election as their chief. And after giving it a lot of reflection, a lot of thought, I felt I had to give them an answer. And other people came forward and asked me as well. Having given that reflection and the background that I have, the compassion that I have, the understanding, the skill and the knowledge, and indeed the experience of my past 30 years, I really felt that I could help out. I could make a difference in this community with the help of a strong council, the present administration, and you know, the wherewithal. Because you know what? I did it once before with the help of everyone involved, and I really feel I can do it again. And that's the reason why, in a nutshell. What can I achieve as leader of Listigouche? Considering that it's 2 years. So what can a leader actually achieve? You have to really seriously think about that. You have to seriously determine through your own thought and through the consultation of your community and the people around you what's possible. And for me, I've given it thought. And this is what I have in mind. On the social side, the community needs to come together. They need to celebrate together. They need to work together. They need to grow together. And in order for the social well-being of this community to be improved, not saying that it's all bad, but there are a lot of social issues to be addressed. Drugs, alcohol abuse, the social fabric within families and the community itself. I hear stories about communities wanting to get together more, you know, like in the old days, and to celebrate and share, and even the whole spectrum of life to come together. And so from the social perspective, I think I can facilitate that with the council also, and with the community. On the actual development of the community, there's two sides to this. One is really about economic and employment development. I really think that I know enough. I have enough experience. I have the contacts. I've been able to develop economic and community development in my previous administration, and I really think that that's what really the people in the community are also looking for. They're looking for basic human deeds like jobs. They want not only part-time jobs, they want full-time jobs. They want to see the community grow. And I think we can accomplish some of that. To what extent, I don't know, because it's all, you know, out there right now. It's really up to how we steadfastly negotiate with government on a lot of these issues, especially in employment development and economic development. However, there are already resources in the community who need to be networked together in order to make that happen. Now, the structural side, that's the good part, I think, because I've been working on a committee for the last 2 years as council member, mandated by the chief and council to oversee a working committee on the building of an elders lodge called the WADESC. And I think that with all the planning that's been done, with all of the architectural work and all of the, you know, the actually some kind of a budgeting process in place for that, you know what? I think that this coming year, that's possible. The other possibility is that we've been talking about a giganaut also. That's going to get built next year in 2013. The WADESC in 2013 also. So those two are two structural components. Highway 132 is coming on stream this summer. There'll be employment there. So there's some structural things that need to be done in the community. So with a strong working council, with the team of administration that's there, and the helpful will of the community, in 2 years, I think we can make a big difference.